Hey, Bill, I heard you wanted to see me.
No, I didn't want to see you.
Oh, well, while I'm here, I thought I'd wish you luck on the new show. You're a fellow CBS star.
Fellow? Are you on CBS?
Yeah, this show.
This show? Oh, gee, I forgot it was on TV. I'm so sorry.
Anyway, since I was on Drew Carey and you're kind of new to the sitcom world, I was wondering if you need any acting tips.
Acting tips?
Yeah.
Craig, I'm William Shatner. Acting tips. No, that's like telling Crabtree and Evelyn how to make goat milk body cream.
I love that stuff. It's perfect for my cracked heels.
Your cracked heels?
Mm.
Wow. Anyway, you're a sick person who needs help.
Okay, Bill. But you remember this. Comedy can be a harsh mistress. Just when you think you've conquered her, she'll pop up and kick you in the teeth, sending you spiraling downward, 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 until you wind up here at 12:30 a.m.
Please don't do that. Don't do that, please.
Thanks for caring, Bill.
Well,
thanks.
I know. I don't care, Craig. I'm just acting like it. I'm that good.
Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Mazda. Zoom, zoom, forever.
Let your applause die away quite naturally. Please know that. Oh. Sit down. Go on, you just. God, for heaven's sake. Sometimes I think your heart isn't really in it. Especially if you're perhaps standing in the front row going. They like to put the crazy people in the front row. So that I can keep an eye on you. I tell you what, it's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. But not such a great day for the that Tea Party candidate, Christine O'Donnell. I talked to her about her last night. I don't know if you know, but she's the woman running for the Senate of Delaware. You know, she's never been married and says she's against all forms of premarital sex, including masturbation. Now, I'm not telling you how to vote, but personally, that's taking it too far. For me, if you want my gentleman's business, you'll have to pry it from my cold, dead hand.
Yeah, babe.
Yeah, that's right. Jeff, you better stop that. Maybe. Anyway, it turns out this Christine O'Donnell... Jeff, knock it off. I can't concentrate. It turns out that Christine O'Donnell may have been a bit wild when she was in college. Apparently, she went to parties and doesn't remember what happened. She may have had sex. And I'm like, whoa! That's the kind of parties I like to go to when I don't even remember if I had sex? Like, I don't even remember if I had sex? And then I'm like, what college did she go to? And then I find out it was Fairleigh Dickinson. And I'm like, oh, well, Not totally Dickinson, just fairly Dickinson.
Well, cock-a-doodle-doo.
Enough of your political commentary, Jack. In your pants.
In your pants. In your pants.
Shut up.
In your
no.
pants.
I'm
pants.
Outsmarted by an appliance one more time. Now, I want to talk about this Christina Donna woman, because it wasn't all parties for her in college. This is true. In the college she went to, she led a symposium on the woman from Lord of the Rings. You remember the woman from Lord of the Rings? Anybody have a picture of one of the women from Lord of the Rings? There's one. So, anyway, Christina... Christine O'Donnell says she admires the female warriors from Lord of the Rings, but she's against integrating women into the US military. So I'm like, okay, so women can't fight the Taliban, but they can fight the cave trolls of Mordor. And this is even better. Her sister is a lesbian, and Christine O'Donnell is against gay rights. And I'm thinking, I wonder if they've ever get into fights about that, you know, like pillow fights. Amazing. A lot of people agree with this woman. A lot of people love this woman. In the last 24 hours, she's raised more than $1 million, which I think is ironic because she's against masturbation, but she's taking money in hand over fist. However.
Go, Craig. Go, Craig.
Now, actually, I don't want to talk about this because it's a very important day today. I don't want to let this day go by. This is a great day, not only for America, but for our friends next door, the Mexicans. It's a great day for Mexico because today is Mexican Independence Day, or as it's known in Arizona, Thursday. Do we have a... All right. Do we have a graphic for Mexican Independence Day? We didn't have any money left for a grab, but it's a magic day in Mexico because it's Mexican Independence. Now, I know what you're thinking, Greg, isn't Mexican Independence Day Cinco de Mayo? Wrong. Or, as they say in Mexico, wrong-o. Because... have I pissed off just about everybody tonight? I have. Anyway, Cinco de Mayo celebrates a Mexican victory in a battle that happened 50 years after the Declaration of Mexican Independence. Today is Mexico's bicentennial, 200 years old. You still look great, Mexico. Your maracas are still perky. I'm 48 and mine are starting to sag.
Sexy.
At least I still have some organic material left.
In your pants.
Exactly. I know. Anyway, look, congratulations, Mexico. 2 centuries free of Spanish domination. Now, some people think Spanish rule couldn't have been that bad because the Spaniards talk with lisps. No, Castilian Spanish, it's true. Mexican Spanish, you pronounce the S, but in Castilian Spanish, they pronounce S like this. It's very hard to be an oppressive colonial overlord when you talk like this. Surrender or face the consequences. Now, people in L.A. were flying Mexican flags everywhere. The Mexican flag is almost identical to the Italian flag. Both go red, white, green. But the way you can tell the difference, the Mexican flag has a coat of arms on it. The Italian flag just is like hands that go, what's the coming to go? Like this. We got a huge Mexican community here in Los Angeles, of course. We got the best Mexican food here. I'm not a fan of some of it, though. I like most of it, but there's some of the Mexican food I don't know. I like the tacos filled with beef tongue. I'm sorry, I don't want to see a taco filled with tongue. Or, wait. Maybe... Maybe I do, because I went to Fairleigh Dickinson, so I... No, no. Maybe not. Now, of course, this would be a great place to take a commercial break, wouldn't it? When the audience just applauded like that, everything was going well. If I had just said, we'll be right back, that it would have been like a regular TV show. That's why I waited. Well, that's better. We'll be back in a minute. Back at me. They don't... The studio audience just waved back at me and I'm like, don't wave back. You're not real. You're just a machine. You're welcome, internet douchebags with nothing better to do. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
Tweets and emails, Craig.
Dump me on bitter, cause you ain't a quitter. I'm a baby sinner, check your damn Twitter. Yeah, complaints, and also emails. There you go. Thanks. Thanks, actually, really, Bob Dylan. I look forward to your letters. This is from Suzanne in San Francisco. Suzanne says, Dear Craig, how can I get my dirty, cheap friend to not want to stay at my place when she is passing through town? She can stay with me.
In your... pants.
No! How do you stop your dirty, cheap... Well, clean up the place and charge her money. She'll be like, oh, this is not comfortable at all. This is from Mallory in Farmington. She says, Hi, Craig. I'm a senior in college and need an awesome Halloween costume. Last year, I was Ginger Spice. Any ideas? You bet I have.
Yeah, babe.
Ginger Spice. What one was Ginger? That was the one, the red-haired Ginger Spice. Yeah. All right. Are they still going, the Spice? They're not still going, the Spice Girls, are they? No, I don't think so. Well, Halloween costume for a senior in college. What age is a senior in college? I didn't go to college. Not clearly. 20, 21, you probably, go as the lady that's against masturbation. Listen, hey, you know, I'm not telling you how to vote. If you're against masturbation and you think that's an important piece of legislation we got to get on with, go ahead and vote. That's your right, that's your democratic right. I don't know how you're going to enforce a law like that, but, you know, good luck. What are you doing?
Creeps me out.
Yeah. This is from Rick in Cedar Rapids in Iowa. Rick says, Craig, what's the best way to tell your wife that you're batting for the other team? Uh-oh. Well, try to... Don't shock her right away. Start off gently, you know, by letting her know... clearly, you want to let her know you're gay. So, you've changed your mind from the wedding. So, probably what you can do is start leaving hints around. Leave, scatter cushions. When, you know, when she's talking, listen. You know, she'll start to figure out that you're gay. If that doesn't work, you know, come home wearing a pair of leather hot pants and with a large mustachioed boyfriend.
Oh, my.
Yeah. That got you going, didn't it, Boney? Yeah. All right, then. This is from Liz in Erie in Colorado. Says, Dear Craig, I did something I wasn't supposed to do with someone I wasn't supposed to do it with. Am I in trouble? Did you just meet up with a guy who gave me the guy? Yeah. Well, it depends if you're telling lies. Yes, that's not good. But it depends on what it is. I mean, I did something I wasn't supposed to do with someone, but yes, you're in trouble. Yes. Now, yes. Now, does it mean that you're in a lot of trouble? Well, it depends on what you did and who you did it with. You'll have to be more specific. Perhaps send a video. This is from Tammy in Cottage Grove in Oregon. See, now why can't I live in a place like Cottage Grove? That was me thinking about Cottage Grove. By the way, Cottage Grove is also the name of a very naughty sexual act.
In your pants?
That's not true, but it sounds like it could be true. No, it's not. Anyway, it's not. You know the CBS Censors kind of looking through the dictionary of Cottage Grove. Google Cottage Grove. It's not. Relax. Anyway, Tammy in Cottage Grove in Oregon says, Hey there, Craig, who's your favorite nerd of all time? Well, I don't know if he qualifies as a nerd, but do you guys ever watch Doctor Who on the BBC? Wait. I didn't ask you to applaud. I like Doctor Who. I mean, the only thing that made Doctor Who better is if he was on CBS. But then he would be an old ginger dude that finds stains everywhere.
Sexy.
Yeah. Apparently. Just trying to get you in the mood for buying stuff. Buy stuff. Bye, stuff. All right, then. We'll be back in a minute. Hey, you know what? I just had this idea. Why don't we, instead of continuing with the show, let's just leave now. You and me, we'll get in the car, we'll rob a liquor store, and we'll go to Vegas. And if we live, okay. We'll get a tattoo. You're right, we'll carry on with the show. So, my next guest is my first guest. Well, yeah, he's my first guest tonight. There's been guests before now, though. But my first guest tonight is the star of the big new CBS comedy, Bleep My Dad Says. It premieres Thursday, September the 23rd at 8:30 on the Great Tiffany Network. Take a look at this.
I just came by to get my stuff. I'm leaving. My buddy's gonna let me crash on his couch.
Where?
L.A.
When?
Now.
Why?
Because.
I see.
So, I'm gonna get my stuff now.
Okay.
Okay.
You sure you don't want to stick around, have a bowl of grape nuts?
I can't.
Why not?
I'm going.
Where?
L.A.
When?
Now.
Why?
Because.
I see.
Please welcome William Shatner, everybody. William Shatner.
Ferguson.
How are you, Bill?
You are such a funny man.
Oh, you're no, so no you're a funny man.
No, you're a funny man.
Yeah, you're a... You. Well, if you do me and I'll do you.
Okay.
All right.
You're a funny man.
Craig, you.
Jeez, man, I don't do that.
Oh, come on.
I don't do that. What? I don't do that.
This show, Bill, looks very good.
Oh, God, I can't stand to look at myself. It's
really? What are you talking about?
I know. You look at it. Oh, my God. Who is that person?
That person is one of the most beloved actors of his generation. Oh. That's who that person is.
Thank you. And I look at it and think, who could love that? You know? So, there I am.
I could love that.
Now,
put that in your captain's log.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
I can't stand that guy. I spent 4 years with people like that.
Oh, Bill, cigars on the roof later?
That's the best invitation I've had.
But Cigars on the Roof, by the way...
Cigars on the Roof, yeah.
It's the name of a club in West Hollywood.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
Are they smoking cigars, or
they... kind of are, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you been... Are you a member? Ooh.
Do you smoke cigars? Do you actually smoke cigars?
I actually do.
Really?
Yeah. But the problem with smoking a cigar is they have to be at the right liquidity. You know, they have to be moist to a certain point. And, well, don't laugh. I mean, if they're too... We are talking about cigars,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we are.
Okay.
Cigars. I'm sorry,
so
there's
moistness...
a large Freudian coach party in
no,
this evening.
No,
but
it hasn't got anything to do with Freud. I'm saying moist.
Right.
And they're laughing.
Yes.
Now, if I were to say a fiery tip...
In your pants.
I can't stand that guy.
I know, but I hate him too. It's disgraceful.
So the question was, what are we going to talk about? And it's already taken care of because that idiot is there.
No. Okay. I'm trying to figure out if you still smoke cigars. I do,
but you had... Here's what happened to me, and you tell me the answer. You give me the answer,
okay.
Whether this is the truth or not. I was given a gift of 100 cigars, long, big, huge, Cuban, big. Yeah, got it. Okay. What am I going to do with them? So I go down to a cigar store near where I live.
Right.
And the guy says, well, you'll rent a humidor, and we'll put it up there, and you'll get it. And when you want, you just come in and get it, and you pay rental. I say, great. So I put it up there. 100 cigars, great cigars. And I leave, and I forget that I've got the cigars up there until a year later. I'm passing by the cigar. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I've got 100 big, fat cigars in there.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to go get one and smoke it.
Right.
Right. So I go into the owner and I say, hey, I've been paying whatever I've been paying all year long. I'm ready for a cigar. And he says, oh, shoot. We had them there for about 6 months and all the little beetles came out. Did you freeze them when you got them?
You don't freeze cigars.
That's what I said. And he said, of course you freeze them, because they've all got little gnats and bugs. And we saw them coming out, and we destroyed all 100 cigars.
No!
Yes! Go!
Well, first of all, Cuban cigars, illegal in the U.S. Second...
I've got a green card, so I'm legal.
Okay. You're legal, the cigars
are not.
Not legal.
Okay.
Therefore,
yes.
The Beatles were illegal...
Beatles. Illegal Beatles.
Illegal Beatles.
They're illegal Beatles.
And illegal Beatles...
Yes?
In the vessel
I'm with
the...
I'm with you, yeah, wherever right, you're no, going.
Stay with me. Illegal Beatles in the vessel with the pestle.
Oh! That's, well, what's his name with the red hair?
Yeah, with Danny Kaye.
Danny Kaye.
Danny Kaye.
All right. No, what I'm asking you is this. What I want to know, because I said to the guy, wait a minute, 100 cigars.
That's
worth
a lot of cigars.
$30, $40 a piece. They could have been, I mean, they must have been very expensive. There were 100 at least.
That's a lot. It's almost.
And I wasn't there
dollars.
For a year.
Yeah.
Human nature would say, the guy hasn't come in 6 months. I'm grabbing a cigar.
No, Bill. You bring too much of yourself to that.
I'm just doing human nature.
No.
Human
San
nature.
Fernando cigar store owners are scrupulously honest.
No. They are screwed.
All right. So did you sue the guy for his cigar?
What am I going to sue? He says, I got Beatles. I didn't want Beatles in my shop, so I destroyed the cigars. I said, but my God, man. That was a lot of cigars.
But wait, does that mean when you smoke a cigar, you hear the Beatle going, no?
It happens to shrimp and lobster.
Yes, but... Yeah, but you don't set fire to them.
Of course you do. That's another shrimp on the Barbie.
Oh, yeah. I see where you're going. Yes,
exactly.
So...
I mean, you put a shrimp in a boiling water, you hear, oh! You put a lobster... On the Barbie.
You don't. Because you put them in the water and the shrimp on the Barbie, so you've gotten it wrong again.
Oh,
and you didn't freeze your cigars.
That's it.
And you could have.
And I went to driving school and I was always going fast in and slow out.
No, that's. Wait. I've noticed a pattern with this audience. When they're confused, they start clapping.
Yes, but they don't laugh when they're confused.
No.
And they're laughing.
Yeah.
So when they clap and laugh, urine.
Urine?
Pig, no. Urine. Urine bleep my father, my dad says.
Now, can I ask you the name of the show,
urine
by the way?
Deep bleep.
The bleep, it's called Bleep, My Dad Says.
Well, it's really called, my father said, but... But the CBS won't let us say, so we put a bleep in there. I wanted to call poo-poo, my dad says.
I don't know, poo-poo sounds a little bit like an entertaining transvestite.
As long as the numbers are there, what
you're
do you
right,
care?
You're right. I can't argue with that. Yeah, as long as you make your numbers, that's fine. Have you done a sitcom before?
No, but I've been on your show.
Well, there you are. Yeah.
What a... What does he mean? What I mean by that is, there's an audience who reacts, and they tell you you're funny or not. Then suddenly they're silent, and you cut that bit out.
We don't cut anything out here.
You don't cut anything out?
No!
Oh, my God, I'm ruined.
No.
There goes my whole reputation. So.
Let's.
No. Yes.
Commercial break.
Okay.
Commercial what? Break.
Who?
Now.
When?
You, me, commercial break.
I wouldn't be behind, not ahead. Now?
Yes.
Let's do a commercial break.
Okay.
I'd love to get into it. I don't know whether we can sustain that humor, but what happens, the energy on a sitcom, that thing, it just bowled me over. I don't know where the hell I was.
Oh, no, it goes nuts.
Yeah. And I had no idea.
They're back.
We're back. I almost said a dirty word.
Oh. Would it be a word like tutti frutti?
Hey. You're not asked for your opinion.
Clap. You know,
that the FCC for years, and that's what was the problem with Howard Stern, the problems he had, was that every time he said that word, they charged him hundreds of thousands of dollars in fines, and finally the fines were so large that they couldn't continue. And only recently has the FCC rescinded some of those laws about what you can say and not say on television.
Really?
Do you have the little machine that goes beep? Like every 5 seconds, when the 5 second delay, do you have a beep?
We got a little machine, Whams, as we put a little flag up that goes Tootsie Fruitsie or Ooh La La.
See, that's so much better than a beep.
Yes, I think so.
You know, if you said, and the thing goes Ooh La La.
Yeah, it goes Ooh La La.
Because that would be fantastic. You could have a contest as how you would like to bleep your favorite actor.
Yes.
Okay? Like, push, poof. What the poof?
Well, cock-a-doodle-doo.
Yeah.
Say, oh, cock-a-doodle-doo.
Yeah. He's another one. What's the other one you do? He always says, shut the front door, he says.
My character says in the thing, oh, cheese and crackers.
Yeah.
That's sort of Midwest and nothing, actually.
They say cheese and crackers, though. Do you enjoy cheese and crackers?
Only if you can swallow it in one bite. Like you take the cheese and the cracker and you pop it.
Why? Yeah, you don't get the crunchy goodness and the moistness of the cheese mixing with the crunchy goodness of the cracker.
I understand that, but you can get another one very quickly.
I see where you're going.
So that's my philosophy. Well, what's yours?
Well, I like to actually chew on my food.
I notice you like to chew on your words too.
When you don't have a script, you got to fill the time somewhere. You know,
with chewing and slobbering
and also, I'm not originally from Los Angeles.
You're kidding me. I would have never have guessed that. Yeah, Flying Scotsman, you.
Bill, don't start. You do it a little bit.
I do.
But you're Canadian, Bill.
No, it comes from the impulse to say something and you retard it. In other words, I'm retarded.
No,
wait a minute. So, I mean, you're about to say something, you think, maybe I better, okay, I will.
So do you have that kind of argument going on in your head all the time?
It's called the committee.
Really? Are you a conflicted person?
No, I've got a single voice saying, get out of here.
Come on.
No, not
you're
get out of here.
You live fairly well inside yourself. You're comfortable. You seem mentally stable.
What happened to your powers of persuasion?
Do you mean...
Perusal.
Perception. Yeah.
That's why I talked that way, because I said perusal and it meant perception. So if I had talked that way and had a moment's pause, I wouldn't have said perusal. I would have said
perception. Yes, I see. Well, I get it.
No way.
How about the...
This is the most awkward sitting position I have ever been in.
Well, you want me to sit around there?
Why am I there? Why have you got me all twisted around? And, oh, geez, if I sit out here... Look, if I'm sitting out here, got my legs crossed, there's no camera. There's the camera,
right,
and there you are.
Come around.
There you go.
There you go.
Now.
Wait
a minute, I got a better idea. Hold on a second. Hang on a second. Let's get down to facts here. How are you enjoying doing this show? I want the truth. Look at me in the eye.
I
want you to look at me in the eye.
I'm doing you. I'm doing my job. Okay. I put my cigars.
Yeah.
And they had bugs in them.
Yeah.
My Bugsy cigars.
Right. You're going to get shot being the...
Bugsy cigars? Right, yeah.
Right through a window.
Hey, you're right. This is kind of creepy.
Is it?
Yeah.
No, you can't look out there because you want to see the eyes, right? Look at me in the eye. See? Is your neck getting stiff and sore? Neck is getting a little stiff and sore,
parts
right?
Parts of me are getting now, stiff. Eye. Parts of me are getting very stiff.
Oh, well, wait a minute now. Go, this is the two-cigar thing on the roof again. Look. Look. Move your eyes over here. Oh, shut up.
All right, right. Well, what?
Look, see? Now, is that awkward?
Not so much.
Oh. Yeah.
But I feel like I'm giving my thigh to the viewer.
And you are. And your waist and your chest and your whole arm to the viewer. And that elegant, distinguished nose.
Hey, in profile, leave off whatever. My nose.
I wouldn't touch your nose.
Yeah, right.
I wouldn't touch it.
It's a very big nose, but only because I have a large penis.
When they applaud, they don't really mean it. You understand that?
They just want us to change the subject. That's why they do it. Please stop talking about that.
Yeah, yeah, and they're laughing. They're going, hey, please stop talking.
Yeah, no.
But your perusal.
Perception?
Perusal of the audio.
Oh, I thought you were going back to remember that.
No, perception's long gone. I've forgotten.
Oh, tell me about it. Yeah,
so listen here. I don't feel comfortable in this seat right now.
That's how I feel all the time, Shatner.
But you're able to cover it better than I am.
Do you want to come back in?
I do.
Well, you want me to sit over there?
Yes.
All right.
That's a really good thing.
Now, I like it here. I like it here because this feels like daytime TV. You got two chairs here like that. I could say, Bill, when did you realize you were a hopeless alcoholic?
And I would say, I don't drink. No, I don't even
know. Let me go.
All right, come on down here.
Anyway. Yeah.
Now you're talking. Now, this is the best way to go. This is an intimate talk. I have a talk show on Bio Channel called Raw Nerve.
Mm.
And this is basically the situation. This is basically how we talk.
Mm.
You feel intimate. You feel like, you know, like maybe you can get... You feel maybe you can get to a truth that otherwise you might not be able to get to.
You really do like cheese and crackers, don't you?
I wish we had a cigar, each of us smoking.
You mean that's not a cigar in your pocket?
No. That's not a cigar. I'm just glad to see you.
Yeah. You know, we're out of time, Bill.
What?
Yeah, we're out of time. Don't start with that. I hate when they
Where do
that.
You get that? We're out of time. Oh, four zeros. Yes,
yeah,
I said that.
Yeah. The guy over there going,
right.
What?
Right, I got it. Yeah. Okay, so what do we do now?
Oh, I think you know.
Yeah, please.
Here's what I know. Thursday night, a week from tonight, at 8:30 on CBS.
8:30
on
CBS, yeah.
Great show, man.
It
great.
Is, yeah. Great. William Shatner, everybody. Now, I'm sorry, my apologies to the very beautiful and talented Sloane Crosley, who was meant to be a guest on the show tonight. And, you know, I talked too long to William Shatner, so we had to move her. And she's going to come back and be on the show very soon. And that's bad for her, but not as bad as what William Shatner did to me during the commercial break. It was awful. I'm kidding. He made me feel like a bug in his cigar. But I think what we learned on the show tonight is that William
Shatner does sometimes talk like this. And that's it. I now have to go and have cigars on the roof. Good night, everyone.